What's going on, everybody? Welcome or welcome back to another episode of Exploring Creativity and Culture, a place where I dive deep to bring you mind-blowing stories, rap and acting tactics, and just the overall understanding of the entertainment industry. Brace yourself, because in today's video, we are diving headfirst into the history of South African hip-hop. With that being said, please, man, hit that like, that subscribe button so that you don't miss any of the interesting things that I will be sharing here on this channel with you guys. So without any further ado, let us jump right into this video and see what craziness we find. Picture this: the streets of Cape Town, block parties, and a group called Prophets of the City, aka POC. POC emerged during the struggle against apartheid, using their music as a form of resistance. They addressed social issues head-on, making hip-hop a voice for the oppressed. Another group that came from the 80s is called Black Noise. Black Noise wasn't just about music, they were about movement, using breakdancing and graffiti to spread hip-hop culture. And a DJ by the name of DJ Ready D, a member of POC, who was a crucial member in this period. His skills on the turntables set the standard for South African DJs, bringing a new level of artistry to the scene. Other key players included BVK, who brought attention to Cape Town's hip-hop scene. The 90s marked a significant period in South African hip-hop scene, because this is when apartheid ended in 1994 and the youth began to adopt hip-hop as their voice, addressing some of the issues that they faced and the challenges they faced during apartheid. Artists like Squadra Camp emerged, blending local languages and rhythms with hip-hop beats to create a uniquely South African sound. Amu, known as the godfather of South African hip-hop, was instrumental in the genre's development. His lyrical prowess and production skills set the bar high for other South African artists. Mr. Devious, another significant figure, used his music to address social issues and advocate for change. Here Comes To Me and The Volume. This group brought about a blend of hip-hop, poetry, and jazz, pushing the genre's boundaries. Gumshev introduced a unique style and perspective, adding to the genre's diversity. Hip-hop Pantsula, aka WHP, popularized Mutswako, blending Setswana with hip-hop, and became a cultural icon. Sukuma
fahla kwangukanga ngise bathonodile sothubula kumkhaka levusha ikhanda onandaba namacala thupha nomphakathi ukhalisa bomama sala awuthi ngikhophe umoya eshbika bofa thanda lo mosha lo mkholwa ngokubona vele ngibuye ejele mothanda ungangibisa umhlwembe nangoke kusivele lendlela ke ngithi sende sukuma kusivele bakubise ngemene mene mama bhete ifange ringa sithula ubabheke kenywa ileze sihlala mfethu siringa ngenombolo bangacafa ukuthi vele le nombolo iqala kuphi so washborofa wash.
Shed a little light for me to see. I hope and trust you wouldn't lie to me. The glowing earth could and might just be.
Hey, yo, forest news takers. For me to carry soul on newspapers is what I do. Greater than how I view nature. Leave it to God. If I know, I'll get at you later. My content, like Malcolm X, a lost crusader. Chilled out like the energy the afternoon's made of. Take a long walk in the park and pass a few neighbors. But the attitudes make this feel like you haters. Can look me in the eye, staring down my shoe.
Compromise, what are you asking of me? Record executives, I'm here to be liked, and you don't have to love me. Do the light to stay in school, see you have to study. Search your roots, you find the trail through our past is bloody. Slave masters got the cash and these bastards run thee. Macrocosm called the world, stole the ghettos ugly. Make your ex on a ballot, I'm like damn it, must we actually vote for these politicians, blasphemous party.
Laws better, I never been scared of adding the special ingredients, so I mature better. Now they look all tell us something, so we all get up. I'm gonna beat the choir, see everybody.
As we entered the 2000s, hip-hop became so very much vibrant in South Africa. We had artists like Tear Gas, WHP, who really went out to the world and brought attention to the South African hip-hop scene. I mean, there was a period where there would be a battle between what is known as vernacular hip-hop and maybe mainstream hip-hop, because now those who didn't have that privilege of understanding the English language were now battling with those ones that, you know, were spitting in English. There was a great divide. So now this is a period where South Africa came to just one understanding. We are diverse as South Africans, but when it comes to hip-hop, we become one. Pro Kid became known for his raw lyricism and storytelling, capturing the struggles and aspirations of South African youth. TKS broke new grounds with their socially conscious lyrics and innovative sound, establishing themselves as one of the leading hip-hop groups in South Africa. Zabs introduced a conscious and introspective style, addressing personal and societal issues with depth and authenticity. Sleeker, who is a former member of Squatter Camp, a vocal advocate for independent artists, used his platform to promote diversity and inclusivity within the hip-hop community. Proverb elevated the lyrical standards of South African hip-hop with his technical skills and versatility. L-Tido reached the gap between underground and commercial hip hop with his hits.
Siyakhipha i-weekend efana plaza nemfibini ngihudula igusheshi insimbi yamahomusha mpintshi ngilikhombe sabapini awunoma bangathini bandahi ngiyo-ome likhekhe lasemakhishini ngithe ma ngifika bruwami ngathi sidudla kayi-one ladlala i-is kwaphuma abantwana joho bafuna ukukhuluma nami bashaya isilungu mpintshami lana ngathi ngizodla two noma one skoko ferezawa waya ngapha bebraya notshwala bubhaya ngigcine sengicaba.
They keep waiting on the promise of the flag, waiting on a Moses that will show them promised lands. Others grow impatient, move away to foreign lands, knowing there's no savior on the way to hold their hands. Mama, you took me to good.
People rhyme, they're trying to get needle time, but none of their feeble minds could ever try equal mine. They even try, give me the evil eye when I rock. They're trying to roll, you ever seen an eagle flying in a flock? You're M'd up between you and I, this track is a do or die. Before I could even kill it, it committed suicide. I give them truth and lies and force them to choose a side. And whoever chooses lies, they should have been crucified. It's a manifestation of verb. The stage was a place of my birth, born with a page and a word.
What else, bro?
And this is amazing at work. You already heard, seen, and touched it, now you're tasting the verse.
In today's hip-hop scene in South Africa, we have seen a great deal of change. I mean, we have artists like Nasty C, Shoma Josie. These artists have went out to the world and they showcase what South African artists can do. I mean, having international features and also pitching up in the international charts, making South African hip hop a recognizable force in the world. AKA became a household name with his chart-topping hits and entrepreneurial ventures. Caspanya Vest as well made history with his sold-out concerts and innovative marketing strategies. Nasty C gained international acclaim with his distinctive sound and lyricism. K.O., a former member of Tear Gas, had a successful solo career with hits like Kara Kara, with hits like Sede recently, you name them. Ricky Rick influenced trends and aesthetics within hip-hop community with his fashion-forward style and music videos. MT represented struggles and aspirations of South African youth with his unique storytelling. I mean, have you ever listened to Manando? Sorry to disturb you while you're watching this video. Please, man, do me the solid. If you like this content, click that like, the subscribe button, so that you don't miss any of the content that I will be sharing here on this channel with you guys. So let us get back to our scheduled program.
Manato was my school, yeah. Manando was gangster, man. He was no wankster. Big homie was my dude, yeah. Big gang was on my sim. He taught me how to play my rim. He was real, wasn't no pretend. To beat your whole squad up, he had no contender.
Blackie, a rising artist, captured the attention of audiences with his raw lyricism and unique style.
I got my foot at the door. I was like, what you doing? Could you do something up for me? Hey, baby, put your back into it. Baby, put your back into it. Baby, put your back into it. I'ma go to racks up for you. Hey, baby, put your back into it. Baby, put your back into it. Hey, could you put your back into it? I'ma go to racks up for you.
A-Reece resonated with a new generation of hip-hop listeners with his introspective lyrics and emotional depth. Nadia Nagai broke stereotypes and paved the way for other women in hip-hop. Vocalistic blended hip-hop with amapiano, creating infectious hits that dominated the airwaves.
Ejo kali gili dope, no gimonobi. Whole hood jumping, muhulu zoli. 10 missed calls, out babe, sorry. Monate ke monate, ah, you know it. And agunya kuli solo. Eitsita uba.
Younger Chief pushed the boundaries of South African hip hop with his versatility and genre blending music. And there you have it, folks, another episode of Exploring Creativity and Culture. Man, I really hope that you enjoyed today's video. With that being said, please, man, click this other video of mine, and I hope to see you next time. Keep it hip-hop.